Also, right now at 5, a new report paints a troubling picture of the metro's gang problem.
Listen to this. The CDC ranks Oklahoma City right up there with Los Angeles in the number of gang-related murders. KOCO's Katy Blakey took that report to the police chief. She's live now with his reaction. Katy.
Well, good evening, Jessica. We are standing on a street here in Northwest Oklahoma City. It could be your neighborhood, my neighborhood. It really doesn't matter. You may think you don't have a gang problem on your street, but the fact is gangs are here and they affect us all. It's a 12-page report full of facts and figures, yet behind those numbers lies a real problem.
We've had the gang problem since the late 80s, and it's grown. You know, we saw a huge growth in the early 90s, and we saw a huge growth in the early 2000s.
Young men gunning down other young men on the streets of Oklahoma City. The study shows between 2004 and 2008, 63 people died during gang violence.
Whenever he came around the family, he always had this smile that it just lit up your heart.
In 2009, Bradley Wani found himself caught in the crossfire. An innocent bystander shot during a drive-by shooting between two rival gangs.
We are a city that we do see a lot of gun violence. So we do have a lot of guns on the street. We probably see more than the average city does.
Police Chief Bill City says his officers are making progress. But change doesn't happen overnight, and it will take more than just law enforcement.
The report doesn't trouble me. The fact that it's so difficult to get a handle on it is what troubles me.
And coming up at 6, how the city is addressing the problem and what they're doing to stop violence on the streets. We're live tonight. Katy Blakey, KOCO, Eyewitness News 5.
Thank you, Katy. Now, the CDC study tracked some information over a 4-year period. The police chief says that since that study was complete, they've seen a big drop in the number of drive-by shootings. Hey.